Alright. Today we are going to be covering Pyro basics. To start, let's drop in a ground plane. To do so, let's go under things have changed in this one. Ground. Collider. Grid. Okay. Grid now. Yeah, it used to be right here. It's under collisions now. Ground plane. That's what we got. We're starting. Then we want a sphere. Not sound. I don't care about sound. And because I was just thinking about that, I want a sphere. Not a flippin' speaker. Okay. Leave it near there is fine. Let's hop over to Pyro Effects to do a smokeless flame for starters. And as you can see, kind of went through, so hit T. Let's move you up. Oh, right. It's autoed up. Let's redo that. You guys. Click on the sphere. Hop in. Sphere level. Delete you. It's just a sphere now. Make it just a little bit off the ground. Yeah, that should be fine. Won't really notice it later. Like before, smokeless flames go over to like 46 or something, so there's actually some pyro. It's done all the calculations. You can see it's going into the floor a little bit. The floor is kind of cutting it off, but when we render, floor goes bye-bye. So, let's talk about our materials. Now before that, let's go scroll in, find a good camera angle. I think that's good there. So let's go over lights and camera control. Make sure you're holding control, click on camera, mix camera from your current viewport. Lock. Use the lock only if you're changing, but we don't want to change, so there you go. Okay, now then, let's see what we're working with. Not bad for a start. So let's click over here, click on a little red, you just test with things to just see what they do. Now then, let's get rid of you, and that does not look good. Smoke's kind of choking it, aren't you? So you could spend hours on just the materiality of this in itself. So we won't. There's just a lot of stuff, like you can mess with the density scale and make that 0.8, go to smoke field, but since we have no smoke on this, make that 0. Field intensity, make that 5. Make it hotter. They all do different things. Like contour is just a line, so clamp at upper limit, clamp at lower limit, decrease you a little bit. Soft clip, press to 4. See if this does much. No, not really much. Fit to range. 8. Actually, let's make that 4 and 4. Enable some noise on it. Fire temperature. Too much. Now that we have that enabled, go over here, mess with this again. Should be doing a little bit. But whatever. Just take these off. Starting to look interesting, but this is getting closer to being cel shaded for video games, but it still looks good. Yeah. Let's say this is exactly what you want, so then just like in the other videos, you would of course organize this. Go to your out, create a mantua. Create a directory where you want it to be. Extra image planes. You'll definitely want SSS. Want to go with multi instead. Base lit and unlit. Find lighting if you actually used lighting, which we didn't. Don't need any of those. create one of our own on our CF color, and we also want direct lighting. Combine lighting per component. That's what I want. There we go. That'll be good. And then select our camera to make sure we got the right one. Camera one, yep. Then you do frame range because this is an actual simulation. Then to finish us off, I want to make this micro. Just straight up PBR. Bit of a slight motion blur. Actually, we can do that in post. Then we want to make this 6x6. And you're good to go. Then just hit render to disk, and it's all good to go. And what you see here, oh, before I forget, don't hit render yet. You want to make sure that this here, not you, the ground plane here is turned off. So that way, all that renders is only your Pyro, nothing else. So, let's say, for instance, that you're making this for a video game. One of the things you would have to make sure that you do is, when you render it, you'd have to make it over like 8 frames if you're having to make this into a spreadsheet, or if this is going to be like an interactable object, then what you'd have to do is make a VDB, right, wrong network, don't care about trace. You'd need to go into your it's under here. And connect this into a VDB. VDB. Particles. Yeah, we don't really have. Let's just call that our. No, doesn't like that anymore. Did it in previous versions. Then, let's see, so it's making it from surface. See if just straight up VDB is any easier. Then it will convert your VDB, I mean, it'll create your Pyro and make it into a VDB, which is geometry. So that way you can bring it out and into the other programs. Unless you just need it as sprites, which will just be placed onto geometry cards. It all just depends on how it's going to be. If it's a side-scroller and flat, cards are fine. Like certain MMOs are fine with just having simulation data being placed onto 2D geometry cards, like grass, sometimes leaves of trees are all just placed onto multiple cards that are all blended together. It all just depends on how it's going to look, but if it's VR, it must be geometry cards. You cannot get away with, because you're looking at 360 degrees. So that covers today. Covers today's tutorial, so on to the next one.